I check the oil, which is down in here. You're supposed to do this every morning before you start your motor, incidentally. You see where that says on there? It's full, because I keep it checked all the time. I don't ever let the service stations check them either, because they can hold your, they'll hold your thumb down like that, clear down on that, and make you believe you need oil when you don't. See that? You can hold it down there, and it won't go down in there. Do it yourself. My dad always figured if he had any problems, if he took a trip, they'd all be done when he got back. I must have inherited that from him. You don't ever get away from them, but then you solve them, maybe. People. I went a lot of different places. Caravan to Alaska, Yellowknife, Nova Scotia, and around the United States, belonging to the Low Club. And of course the slabs, if you haven't heard of the slabs, that's the thing of all, to be with the loners at the slabs. They spend the winter down there. All types of people from all places come to the slabs.
Sounds good to me.
I got one for you.
Oh, I'd even take two.
I got two. Okay? New arrival! New arrival!
I wish you'd gone one of the other factories.
Good to have you here.
Oh, you hung real good.
Hi there! Hi there! So glad to see you here. This is the guy that missed a camp out, and when we found him, he had a triple bypass. That was 2 months ago, and here he is.
And here's Duchess. You know Duchess?
Hi, Duchess.
How are you? Glad to see you.
He's over there. Come on.
Hi, Charles. Good to see you back.
Glad to be back.
Yeah, I was going to say, I bet your rocket is too.
Yeah, I got ready to come out and see my friends where they're all out here at the slabs. And the doctor says, well, I shouldn't go out. He said, if something happens, he didn't think there was any doctor in the area that could take care of me. But I told him, my friends are there and I'm going out.
For 25 years, I drove a school bus, and I'm sure it was easier than this. But this is my lifestyle, and I like it, and it's the only way to be. So,
I spent my whole life raising kids and raising husbands. You know, they're like kids sometimes. And after I lost my husband, it's been 11 years now, the kids were all grown and gone. So I decided it's my turn. I had a big, beautiful home. I upped and sold it. And this is my home, right here.
This is one I wrote a few years, in fact, I guess it says 1980? Here's to the lows of the loners on wheels, the people and places and things it reveals. The camp out, the rallies, the great get-togethers, the highways and byways and all kinds of weather. A friendly hello and the nice smiling faces upon your arrival from faraway places. It's all such a pleasure wherever you go to meet all his friends who belong to the Lowell. It's helped, literally got people out of wheelchairs, I know that for sure. And it's been a great thing for a lot of people that probably would have been staring stupid at four walls if they hadn't have joined this club, no matter. It just is. It just is.
In the trailer next to mine, in the trailer next to mine, there's a gal that's 69. Her husband goes out fishing and don't come home till 9. He says, I'm awfully tired, dear, and that's a very good sign. There'll be nothing doing in the trailer next to mine.
Wherever we go, with Helen and I are together, they always ask us, are y'all twins? And we say no. And then I go into this little spiel. Well, we have the same mother, the same father. We were born the same year, the same day, the same hour. We're not twins.
What are we?
We're triplets.
We grew up in a hospital operated by the Salvation Army. People didn't want to come in and adopt us. They didn't want to adopt three. They couldn't afford three. And then when we were about 2 years old, we went into this children's home. And as we look back, we think that they were very good to us. On occasion, there was one or two that didn't know doodly about children.
Some parents would come every Sunday to visit their child. We had nobody to come to see us because we didn't know where our folks were. But there was this old man that always come to see the triplets. We called him Grandpa.
When we were growing up, somebody made up this song about the burner home, which we lived. And we're going to sing it right now.
There is a burner home not far away, where ham and butter serve three times a day. Oh, how those burners yell when they hear that dinner bell. Oh, how those burners eat three times a day.
Oh, oh, oh. Well, they told us all our lives we couldn't sing.
Well, you know, we did play an instrument.
That helped.
And that helped. Ellen played a baritone, and Evelyn played the slide trombone, and I played the tuba.
This is me and my family, my parents and my brothers and sisters, and I'm the little one, and the dog Sport. Way back in about 1914, I guess. And then we, in Tacoma, Washington. And then my brothers and dad got rheumatoid arthritis, so they told us to move out of there and go to Wenatchee and eat vine-ripe tomatoes, so all they had was a covered wagon. So it took us 10 days to go from Tacoma to Wenatchee in a covered wagon and over the old Blewett Pass Road, and I'm sure we walked most of the way. So then about 10 years later, they sprung up with this 1913 Overland car that had the old carbide lights on it that you had to get out and light a match to. So in 1920, we went back to Kansas in that thing. Took us 6 weeks, and I think we walked half of the way with that. We got a lot of walking done in our, a lot of walking. But while I was in Kansas, I accumulated a horse, which I called Old Swift. He was probably the slowest horse in Kansas, but to me, he was a fast horse. His name was Swift. And then we got back to Washington, and then I accumulated a bicycle and a dog. Of course, it was a little faster than the horse. And the dog was faster than me and the bicycle both. Then it went on, and time marches on, and then in 41, 42, I went into the service. And I ended up even driving a tank. And that was me in the service. long time ago. So here I am down the desert.
Zing, boom,
the game's all here.
Now's the time to roll the barrel.
For the gang's all here.
Were you two both in the Army at the same time?
No. She was in, she came in, you came in as a PFC. See, I came in as a First Louis.
How did you get in like that?
Because I was a nurse.
Oh.
And they needed nurses, so well, they gave them rank.
Well, you see, I was only there 3 months, so they made me a sergeant.
Well, that was all right.
Not too shabby, was it?
No, indeed.
Because I told them they didn't know what they were doing. I wanted to go home. I'm not kidding you. And then they had us, we were instructors, and we didn't have nothing to show we were. We all had size 42 coveralls. They brought them in a bale of hay, men's coveralls, motor transport. And we had all the same size. You'd roll the things up to your knees, and the sleeves come up to here, and the pocket come clear around the front, those size 42s. And you couldn't tell where you was coming or going.
Well, the trousers must have come up here.
Oh, they did.
Oh, we ain't got a barrel of money. Days may be cloudy and sunny, but we'll travel along, singing our song, side by side. We don't know what's coming to
us. Yeah, I don't think Helen mentioned this about the Lowe's, that whenever you're traveling to a rally, and if you have a male companion, you travel each in his own rig.
She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. Did you get it?
The best thing about the traveling alone is three F's: freedom, friends, fellowship.
Helen, I agree with you. Freedom, fellowship, and friends. I'll go along with you.
You have a home somewhere.
I got a home.
In Wenatchee.
In Wenatchee. That's my cat's home.
I sold my home, bought me an RV, and away I went. And the way I've been going.
It's the only way to go.
And when I get tired, I go stay with my daughter about 3 months. And then I go visit my other daughter, stay about 6 months.
You make them happy twice, once when you get there and once when you leave.
No, they're always sad when I leave.
No, are they sad when you leave?
I made my mother happy twice, once when I got there and once when I left.
Well, I have a little grandson. I have two or three of them. So, but anyway, when he was in primary grade, the teacher wanted him to write a paper. And so my grandson wrote about Grandma. Would you like to hear what he said?
Gee.
Yep.
Gee.
It goes way back. It says, My grandma is great friend and grandma. She is a person you would not believe. My grandma can sing a song and not get tired. My grandma can run a race and come in last and get a trophy just for running.
Well, you are a good grandma.
That's good. Well, they tell it like they see it. You know.
But he says, I love my grandma.
Oh, that's nice.
That's good.
Come on, we're going to, come on over to here. We're going to, okay, come here, Duchess. Mm-hmm. See, Joshua Tree here?
Yeah.
If we went in and found maybe a big enough camping area, he said that this could be crowded. But now, do you want to go clear to 29 Palms? It's another 15 miles. And then come in by the visitor center and then try to find a place to
That visitor center, unless they've moved it, is down and you go up to 29 Palms, unless they've changed it. I don't know.
I've never been. I just figured that
Here's 29 Palms right here, Duchess. And in order to get there, you either have to go up through this road or come around here.
Do we want to find a place that we can, big enough that we could all get into when the other group comes, or...
Well, according to,
pardon me, but where will they find us if
Mary,
we don't?
Well, she,
I'm going to tell you something. We said, keep sitting here talking. They're going to be there and camped and gone by the time we get there.
No, they won't be.
I'm lonesome, but I'm happy. Rich, but I'm broke. And the good Lord knows the reason. I'm just a cowboy. From Dallas to Austin, the ranges I know, I drift with the wind, no one cares where I go.
I started traveling with my parents when I was real young. And I got a little older. The California Packers came to Washington, and they fascinated me with their stories. It was like the gold rush in California. I was probably different than my family because I didn't want to settle down. They all wanted to settle down and have families and get permanent things. And to me, that was a waste of time. I wanted to see the world. So I started out in a covered wagon and graduated up to bicycles and ponies and horseback and cars, airplanes, motorhomes. Somewhere along there I had a tent or two. Now I'm headed for the Concorde. When I make that, I'll probably start all over again. No place else to go. You start at the bottom and go clear at the top. Where else is there to go? You gotta go in between there someplace.
I don't know. Your sneaky friends.
Huh?
Look at this.
Duchess, look at this guy's hat. Wait till he passes the rig.
Huh?
He's got a wolf's hat on.
He's probably keeping his ears warm, too.
Probably is, too.
These rocks. You know how these rocks were formed?
How?
Old Mother Earth. Old Mother Earth.
Stop that.
You want me
to run up to the top, would you?
You want me to run up there? I was going to sing you a song then, too.
Okay.
I've been on the mountain. I've seen the other side. I've been on the mountain, and my soul is satisfied.
Okay, did you bring it?
Breakfast?
Yeah.
If I build the fire, you make the breakfast.
Look how smooth and even and level.
Yeah. Well, how about that? Are.
This one, too.
Look at that.
Here
look
comes a man.
What more could you ask for? Hey, there's a motor home down there.
It's more like God's country.
Oh, look at that. Now, well, we got to... You want to walk up to the top of that?
Not me.
Just thought I'd ask. Don't say you weren't invited. Why, some people are scared. Don't ask me why they're scared. I can't imagine anybody being scared of... Well, some people are scared of the dark, and some people are not. Some people are scared of... driving, some people are not. I wasn't scared of the dark or driving or anything else. I guess I never got scared, but maybe I would have been scared.
Then I never worry about being attacked or murdered or anything. That doesn't even enter my mind.
Well, I have no problem either as far as worrying about parking alone, because I feel where I park, it's well lighted, such as the rest areas. And one time I couldn't find a place to park, so I saw this used car place, and there happened to be a space over there. So I went over there and parked the night in that space. And I said, next morning I said, boy, I better hurry up and get out of here, or they gonna try and sell this motorhome.
most exciting thing was at Chanticle, Oregon, midnight. One time this guy come up, two guys come up and rattled a trailer at midnight. And I asked them what they wanted, and they wanted me to get up and give them some gas. So I suggested they go to a service station over there, and they suggested that they were asleep. And I said, what do you think I am? And they said, oh, come on, we just need a little gas to get to the river. And about that time, it upset me. And I said, I'll give you three choices. You can either go to the service station and get some gas, I'll turn my dog out on you, or I'll shoot you. It was just that simple. Up with their hands and said, we don't want any trouble. And I said, that's the smartest damn thing you said since you got here. In fact, I said, I'll count to three and I'll give you that choice again. I may not count to three. He said, we're leaving, we're leaving. I said, goodbye, that's the second smartest damn thing you said. So it was kind of nerve-wracking. Well, I wasn't too scared because I had a gun on him. If it gets to the nitty-gritty or me or them, it's not going to be me. Let's put it that way, it's just that simple.
Sometimes when I stop and get out of the motorhome, somebody, male or female, will come up and say, you little thing, drive that? I said, you betcha.
I am going to attach this hose, hopefully plunge the polar plunger and let the stuff fly. Hopefully not on me.
So, first thing you do, oh God,
I'm a little bit worried about this.
Oh, what I was afraid of.
If while traveling I should note a fellow broke down, I shall stop and render all possible aid.
Fame and fortune for dumping the crap.
There she blows.
I went to a workshop that was on tires, and one of the things they said was, don't hit the brakes when you if you have a blowout. Stay off the brakes. So I had a blowout going up the mountain, and I could hear them in my head saying, don't hit the brakes, don't hit the brakes. So I just gradually kept my foot down. It was so hard not to, and eased off and holding on like this, and it's going like this. But I got off, and nothing happened, and I called road service.
Well, greetings.
Howdy.
Howdy.
You've been to the Fox River.
Yeah.
Where is it?
Hmm?
Where is it?
In Illinois.
Oh, that's a long way.
Just out of Chicago, about, oh, west about 50, 60 miles, in a little town of Ottawa.
Oh. I missed Miss Chicago one time.
Yep.
They tell me you just go down the road here and you can't miss it. You got to be kidding. I miss Chicago by 30 miles.
Well, I'm looking for a guy that was supposed to be here.
What's his name?
His name is Lucky.
Oh, well, he's here.
He is?
He's the one that...
He hauls water.
Oh, he hauls water?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure he's here.
Well, he's over there or someplace. How are you doing?
We're getting him filled.
I'm upset.
Desde uno hasta veinte, por favor. Uno, todo la clase.
Uno,
dos, tres,
cuatro, cinco, seis, siete.
Yeah, it took me about 50 years to develop what I've got here now. I'm still working on it. Give me another 20 and I'll have it in pretty good shape.
Well, when I first started telling jokes, my sister and I, we were taking a trip over in Australia. And so at the end of each happy hour, this one lady always told a joke and everybody enjoyed it. So I said, gee, that's a good idea to have a joke or two after our happy hour. They like these kind of risque jokes that have a surprise ending. Nothing dirty, no bad words. I don't tell jokes like that.
How are you gonna pick your joke for this afternoon's meeting?
You want me to read it? No. Like Ben Franklin is famous for kite flying, and the day he was flying his kite, and he ran out of string, so his wife came running out and said, you need another piece. And Ben said, well, that's what I wanted last night, and you told me to go fly a kite.
Don't worry about me. It's all over now.
And when a low man is in attendance at a low dance, he shall endeavor never to dance with the same lady twice.
It can't be controlled. One is warm, next day is cold. Don't pity me, 'cause I'm feeling.
What you want me to do?
Well, I want you to just bring all the goodies you got in your rig over out here, and I'll get all the goodies in my rig.
Okie dokie. I'm a-coming. I'm coming right now.
Here's to us, and here's to the Lowe's, and to anybody else that want to join us, okay?
talk till my ship will be sailing back to Kona. It's a grand old place that's always fair to see. You're telling me I'm just a little Hawaiian and a homesick kind of boy. I want to go back to my fish and my boy. I want to go back to my little grand shack in Kealakeha, Hawaii, where the huma huma nupa nupa awa awa go for goodbye.
A tiny table for two. Breakfast, I'll be making his breakfast. He'll be taking his shave and his shower. My happy hour. The coffee is steaming. Oh boy, what I'm dreaming while I'm cooking.
Hi.
And that's what I'm
What's up?
Making. What are you doing?
Just switching the solar panel so it gets the sun for the rest of the day. Of course, I'm also on my way to heaven. This is the first step. I go now.
You want to tell me where you were last night? Are you knocking on my door at 3 o'clock this morning? You hear me? Do you hear me talking to you? Well, you promise not to do that some more? Just let me out. Just let me out one more time. Just let me out one more time. Yeah.
Typical load. The only reason I volunteered for this job was so that I could see how much mail I get myself.
I don't know about when I take it apart.
Now, I'll tell you what. We'll
get, come on over here.
There's some boxes right over yonder. Get them because I want those two.
Is this it?
Plastic cartons.
Oh, you want the plastic?
Yeah,
oh,
right.
Okay.
Oh, mucho gracias. Mucho gracias.
All ready for you. You're right enough for other people, though. We've got plenty of them in here.
This is a great day in Frank.
Here, Ray, I
want
to give you a hug.
Good. Hell, I'll be back again tomorrow.
Oh, well, in that case, maybe I could have given you one, too.
I'll come back again tomorrow.
Marvin, what are you going to do today?
Not very much.
Not very much?
Just as least as I possibly can.
Least as you possibly can.
Just as hard as I can.
You ain't going to cut wood?
No.
Not going to cut wood?
Mm-mm.
You're not going to go dancing?
Well, I may go dancing, yeah.
You may go dancing.
When we were growing up, we had beans on Monday, beans on Tuesday, beans on Wednesday, beans on Thursday, beans on Friday. Saturday we had beans, Sunday we had beans.
Two times. I bet you didn't have any gas problems, huh?
We're shooting all day.
We got along pretty well, but we would disagree with each other, and sometimes we'd come to blows, and we'd wrestle and all that stuff. Biggest fight they had was over horseshoes.
Yeah, who was the winner?
Well, I was standing by rooting for both of you. I'm marking this line here because the women pitch 10 feet from the stake, and men over 70 also can pitch 10 from the stake. And the men pitch even with the stake on outside the pit. Since we've grown up and retired, we still like to participate in activities. And Well, maybe I better go back, you know, back a little further. We used to play a softball, and we were on a softball team for about 3 years, and really, I would say that was about the happiest years of my life. Mm-hmm. And then now that we're playing horseshoes, and that too almost takes the place of the softball we used to play.
Aye, aye.
Aha. That is a ringer.
She got a ringer. Well, I may have gotten one too.
We've traveled all over the country just playing horseshoes. Maine, Connecticut, New Mexico, Japan, Korea. We've had a good time playing horseshoes.
Two dead.
Two dead.
Two dead.
Helen killed it.
Evelyn was talking about how having a husband and having children, that helped with fulfilling a lot of her things in life. But I never had a husband, and I never had children. But, you know, at my sister's children, at my sister's, when they had babies, I was there for every one of them. And so I feel like I'm a good aunt to them, good old aunt, you know.
What's the score, Pat?
22 to 10.
Ooh! Well, Evelyn?
That was a good game.
And George and Helen.
Thank you.
And George beating you.
Yeah. My turn's next.
How many of you over there are single?
Oh!
tell me about being single. What's it like being single?
Oh, it's
fantastic.
What's it called maturing in life?
We don't want everything.
You handle your own money and your own bed.
And you don't have to wash dishes if you don't want to.
You don't have to make your bed
if you don't want to. You don't have to cook for anybody if you don't want to.
Once in a while you wash dishes for somebody else.
And have the greatest friends in the world.
Not me.
I wish I was single, oh then, oh then. I wish I was single, oh then. I wish I was single, my pockets would jingle, and I wish I was single again.
You can take a bath when you get ready. You don't have to worry about somebody telling you smell.
A good point. Although aftershave ought to take care of that.
Yeah, a little aftershave takes care of that.
What about if you fell in love again? How many people here would get married again?
Never.
I'm not against it. I won't say never, but might have an affair, but never get married.
I fall in love.
I've been single all my life because I like to be single. Why be double when you can be single? If you're double, you got double trouble. If you're single, you only got single troubles. Of course, maybe if you're double, you got double happiness too. But then on the other hand, each has his good points. It's just a matter of which one you want to go for. And I prefer being single, but I also like to be around people. Because if you're around people, you're single, but then you don't have somebody telling you what to do and what not to do. And actually, there's a lot of single people that are happier than a lot of these double people I've met during the road.
The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and I cried.
Should I ever suspect that a low man and lady has fallen in love, I shall know deep inside that this is the way God and Mother Nature intended man and woman to be.
How much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
I got to be in Lowe's when my second wife died. Went to California, Washington on an invite from my sister who was a Lowe. Met Frances at a dance. Frances was looking for a guy with a motorhome.
Mm-hmm. But only a motorhome.
We worked on getting married for a while and was hit or miss and had a big trip planned to visit our kids. And it didn't seem proper to live together in the same motorhome, visiting our kids as singles. So we went off and got married. But we were in love. And we're happy to be alumni because it allows us to associate closer with our old friends in the Lowe's.
The word is alumni.
Alumni.
We go over that all the time.
Why do you think it's so important to mix up with these guys around here? Men and women.
Well, we're both human.
That's it. Now then.
And we both like
each other.
Opposite sexes, regardless of our age.
That's right. No matter whether
and
they...
friendship, loveship, courtship,
friendship.
Any old thing.
Then there's a lot of other kind of, what would you say? Would you really say BS?
Well, I wasn't going to bring that up. I'm going to keep it good.
Keep it clean.
Sex? That's a personal question.
About sex, worry about sex. Sex is long time ago, my friend. And I don't cook, I don't wash windows anymore. So, my friend, I go fishing in Baja. It's a lot more fun than spend your life worry about sex.
We don't worry about it.
What is that?
Age.
What is that? I baked a cake the other day for a party, and it was called Better Than Sex Cake, and I think that's the most sex most of us have had for a while.
You know, there were two ladies walking down the street, and Mary said to Maude, you know, all this old sex just gives me a pain in the neck. And so Maude said to her friend, "Why, Mary, you're doing it all wrong."
You used to pick this stuff up and make salt shakers and stuff out of it. That all comes off, and then they made it illegal to it. I made some lampshades and salt shakers, and these have got little fish hooks on them. See them? I mean, they're not flimsy either. Look at that.
Look how long they are too.
Look at that. If you want to settle down and not move, sit on one of those. And if you don't want a bouquet of flowers, don't pick them.
Well, I wonder how they smell. Shall I go smell one?
Yeah, we want to smell one. How about that? You want to make a pitch of teepee down there someplace?
Hey, do you two ever think about death?
No, I never do.
No?
Yeah, why think about that when you got
coming,
so much
it's coming anyway, so why think about it?
That's a dumb thing to think about.
As long as we're alive, we're going to enjoy it, right? Yeah.
Death never did bother me because it comes part of life, so you just well enjoy life and not worry about death. But on the other hand, you should be prepared for it, not to have other people have to do it. So I took it upon myself to prepare my own headstone, and I had a picture of the motorhome put on it, and the date of when I was born, and the other one hasn't been finished yet, and the years I put in the service, and then I had road to trees and highways, and said, told you I didn't feel good, but I'll see you down the road. Besides, I told you I didn't feel good. That's what's on my headstone in Wenatchee, Washington.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Old Pancho Villa was there, too. He had a tent.
He didn't sleep out in the open.
He slept on the run. He could sleep riding bareback on a horse. Did you know that?
Oh, I'm not surprised.
Sure, he had the thing. His legs were so long they put straps and tied his feet together and take me to your leader. Did I away, boys, or what did I away? I ask you now as a personal friend, what did I away? She way to Washington, boys, she way to Washington. I'll tell you now as a personal friend, she way to Washington. What did Tennessee, boys, or what did Tennessee? I ask you now as a personal friend, what did Tennessee? She saw what Arkansas, boys, she saw what Arkansas. Why'd you come to my party tomorrow? I'm going to be 86. Anybody interested? Well, you may be that old someday. Good luck to you. I hope you've enjoyed life as much as I have. Besides, I'm going for 100 anyhow, so I got a lot more places to go. Maybe these rock piles will be bigger by the next go-around. They seem to grow all the time. Cold country, let's get out of here, huh?
Tuna. Tuna with onions and garlic and everything else in it.
Yeah, this is my first deli mold I've ever made. I'm very proud of it.
Hi, how are you?
I'm going to get some of that.
Have you been around?
It gives me great honor, an honor of all these low standing out here today, Duchess, to crown you our queen of the slabs for today.
Oh.
Oh, and yay! Yay! She's a grand old gal and a super low pal, and forever and ever may she be. She's the emblem of that wonderful balloon that she gives to us all for free. She's our queen right now, so let her take a bow. So loyal and true is she.
Macho young man, he was always standing in front of the mirror admiring himself. He went to the beach quite often and then came home, and before the mirror he admired his beautiful tan. But there was one part of his body not tanned. He says to himself, I must do something about that. He goes to the beach and buries himself in the sand, exposing only that part he wanted tan. Two ladies, Duchess and her friend, were walking along the beach. And Duchess says to her friend, "Come over here and look what I found." And Duchess to her friend said, "When I was 10 years old, I was afraid of it. When I was 20 years old, I was curious about it. When I was 30, I admired it. When I was 40, I enjoyed it. When I was 50, I paid for it. And when I was 60, I prayed for it. Now that I'm 70 plus, the darn things are growing wild."
Oh, that was good. 100 years or 100,000, whatever comes first.
Happy birthday, Duchess.
Thank you.
One of our favorite lows.
Duchess, are you planning on not traveling anymore?
Well, yes and no. I'm not as enthused about it as I used to be, but I haven't given it up entirely. But then common sense will tell me to use a little more brains than what I have in the past of getting up in the middle of the night and taking off and crossing your fingers and hope you get there. It'd be common sense to tell you a better caravan with somebody or something. But we have to see. I got driver's license coming up and eye problems coming up. And so we're just playing it by ear now.
Do you want to travel more?
Well, sure, anybody that's traveled don't want to stop, but then you got to use a little common sense about it, whether you want to or whether you don't. You can't do everything. After all, I'm not a kid anymore, so let's face it. I don't want to end up out in the tules there by myself someday, twitching and nobody knowing where I belong. I got to get back to that headstone, you know. I don't want to spend all that money and then not be there. So somebody find me out here in the boondock someplace, and that'd be kind of dumb now. You got to admit that. So let's use a little common sense and take it day at a time.
Well, I've enjoyed my life. Of course, you have your sad moments, your bad moments, but you don't like to think about those. You think about the happy times you have spent wherever you go.
Well, I think I've lived a full life, but I think there's still a lot. It hasn't been the fullest because there's too many other things to do. And, of course, I think at the present, I think I have enough money, but it sure would be nice if I had like a little more do-re-mi. I could do a little bit more. But I'm having fun.
No, I'm gonna say, "Howdy-ho."
Adios.
I'll see you down the road.
Oh, bless you, okay. My child. You take care and take me with you. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
I'm going to have to go and find somebody. I can't sit out here by myself and talk to myself and talk to the cactus. Why don't you come back and I'll go with you?
Why don't you just come go with me?
Okay, I'll see you down the road. I got to go now. Oh, wow, my pants stuck to me. Oh, I got that. Wow. It wasn't the cactus, it was the sun. Goodbye.
I'm lonesome, but I'm happy. Rich, but I'm broke. And the good Lord knows the reason. I'm just a cowboy. From Dallas to Austin, the ranges I know, I drift with the wind, no one cares where I go. I ain't got a cent in these old worn out jeans. Stop eating steaks and go back to beans. I'll pick up a 10 spot in Houston, I know, riding the Bronx in a big road.